higher. Right, I've gone over and I've done the envelopes on that character, so we should be able to take him back into UDK now. Messed around with the ones around here, up on the arms, and I think there was a few bits on the legs. This Windows Aero just crashed. Because as I've mentioned in this series a few times, the memory and video graphics card are pretty crap on this computer. Right, so let's go. I want to save it first. Save scene as Epic. Oh God, which one was it? That one, 5. And then go export. Export all. Epic Mio 4 test. I'm going to do 5 this time. So I can always go back to that previous file in case this one's messed up when we get into UDK. You know, it's always best to, as I mentioned God knows how many times, to save your work in stages. And blah blah blah. What's that? Nothing to worry about. Close. Right, jump into the latest version of UDK as of the 20th of August 2012. Wherein the July build of UDK, which is the one that's available at the moment. Now, I'm not going to call this character Epic Me when I import him in. I'm going to call him Adrian. Then I know who he is. And in fact, I don't even like that material. As I think I showed you in one of the videos back, I didn't put that one on when I did the first attempt at importing him. And I'm pretty sure that Maya hasn't got that texture that's on him now in its directory, so UDK will not find it probably now. But we'll just chuck one on. I've got several different textures for that character, so he could have one of many. But we'll quickly chat this on when this decides to fire up. Yeah, let's just have a quick look. I really don't like that texture, and I haven't got any normal maps for it either. Come on. And I've already got all my stuff in here, and so we could test this character almost immediately. I want to test him with the UDK animation first, though. So I've got my character directory open. Now, the one that's already called EpicMe04, as far as I remember, is Ivan, that we did in the Max videos. Let's just have a look here. Oh no, I've imported it as Ivan, right, okay. So now we're just going to go to the my character directory and go import documents Maya projects default scenes Epic Mio 5 test open and then rename it as Adrian, and then I'm going to call the package Adrian Assets, and then the group. Oh no, actually we don't need to do a group if we've got import and materials and textures checked, so we'll go okay. No smoothing group information was found. Not the end of the world. I can go back and redo that again. I forgot that actually. This is just to see if all's well with the skin modifier now. now that I've done some work to it. I think I know where it's going to mess up a bit around the I'll show you whilst that's working. Around this sort of area here, I didn't really work on that well. I worked on the arms, the neck, the head, the feet, the legs, and so on. So we'll let this do all its stuff. See how badly it gets the textures. Yeah, that's telling me my texture wasn't a power of 2, and I've explained that before. 512 by 512, 1024. Sorry, not. It doesn't matter the diameter and the width being the same. It's a power of 2 is 128, 512, 1024, 2048, 40, 96, and blah blah blah. Ah, right, it doesn't look too bad, although it's got that texture wrong on the body. That's alright. Right, let's quickly find one to put on him. So I know which one straight away will work. So here's the material. I'm going to open that quickly. Then I'm going to drop it down. And I'm going to find the texture I want to put onto it. I'm looking for character 2 here. Character 2. Darth me, find his material. That one. Or texture. And then go find object in content browser. So with that selected now, the actual material, there's the texture there, or a different one. Got that one there. Either of these will work on him. We'll go with this one here, you know, the usual one I normally use. Actually, is that a material? No, it's a texture, right, okay. And then we shut down Darth Me. We open up the character, sorry, not the character, the material editor. For Christ's sake. That's the content browser, so it must be this one. No. This one then. Finally, click on that. No, sorry. We go hold down T on the keyboard. And there we are. Delete that thing. And that parameter. And the UV. And then just plug him into diffuse for the moment. Hit the ticker. And now we should have the right material applied to him now. So he was this one here. And there we are. And we've got several we could put on him. One thing I've got to do with that material though. Find it quickly now. Is make it double-sided. It's that one. And that way it won't be see-through when you're looking at where his neck and torso meet. And then we'll quickly chuck a UDK animation on him and see how he looks. So right, animes. We'll chuck the base male ones, the UDK ones. Ah, right, I've still got a couple of feet problems there, see that? And a leg problem there, needs fixing. But all in all, he's looking a lot better. See, playing the idle animation now. So there's only a couple of little bits of skin to do. And you just keep flicking backwards and forwards. re-importing it, but I'm going to save it now because overall I like the I'm happy with everything so far. There's just a couple of little skin issues to address back in Maya, painting the weights more. So I'm going to go save. Next combined. Next Luther. Content. Characters. And then go save. So that's Adrian fully saved now. As I mentioned in the previous Maya video, I want to show you the Maya version of the UT mail. So we're going to go new scene. Oops. Open scene, and we're going to open the Maya version of the UT mail now. I've got the textures on in, but they will, the one that you can download off my website does is not textured, it's exactly the same as the one you'd get off of Epic Games. So there we are, that's the UT mail. You could import this character directly into UDK as he is by exporting them out as an FBX now. So remember, if you haven't watched the previous Maya video, well, you should have done, you should be watching all of them, go on to my channel, my website, which takes you directly to the goodies page down to the bottom, and this is the UT mail Maya version here. Now instead of importing, obviously this is a rigging series and the whole purpose of this is to show you what to do with this. What you would do to rig this character, now you've obviously got to get rid of all the mesh parts and then rig your character to it. So you just delete all this lot. There are two skeletons here, and so you've got to get the right one. I've got a biped and the epic based skeleton. The biped should easily be, we should be able to select that first. Oh no, we've got the epic skeleton here just by selecting the roots. So you can see the other skeleton there. We'll grab that. And then you can see we've got the BIP pelvis, or the epic one there. So we'll move the BIP one out of the way quick. Press W on your keyboard. So here you have the biped, and there you have the epic based skeleton. Select the hips. So you've got the B underscore hips there. Same with the biped, select his hips, and you've got the B, the BIP 01 pelvis. I don't know if there's a root bone in that. I don't think there is, no. There you are. And you would obviously, when you add the skin modifier to this as it was, you know, when they're both in place of it in front of each other, make sure let me get there. You've got that bone selected once when you add the skin modifier to your mesh, as we did in a previous video of Maya. And then if you've got other if your body's made up of components, i.e. a torso, arms, legs, feet, like this one was just 5 minutes ago, then you have to add a skin modifier to each part and edit the envelopes in those separately. It actually works out a lot easier having your body as components, because then you've got less envelopes to do in each section. It may seem, when you first think about it, that it's going to be more difficult having more envelopes, but they aren't more envelopes in the single mesh, they're just envelopes in the individual pieces, which makes it a lot easier. And that's why game creators generally use modular characters, because they're easier to rig. And every single one that I've ever seen, so for example, I'll show you, oh no, I haven't got a Maya scene file of GTA 4 characters, but I've got Nico in a 3DS Max file format from Rockstar Games from GTA 4, and he is in a modular style. And then characters from CryEngine Games and Ubisoft, they are also modularly built as well. Obviously there'll be exceptions as well, but generally it's much easier to have a modular character. And by modular, let's quickly open, for those of you who don't know what that means, let's just open the UT mail again. Don't save that. Modular meaning legs, boots, arms, shoulder pads, head, and then a mask if you want one of them as well. Torso. I generally call that body though, that because it's where the body armor is on my characters. And I don't have shoulder pads on my characters because they're for girls in the real world, other than American footballers, and I know a lot of you guys are American. But generally in Great Britain, the only people that wear, the only humans that wear shoulder pads are girls, trying to get more square shoulders. And so it looks really gay to me seeing it in a game when a character's got these big shoulder pads. Anyway, that's the so if you wanted to use this character instead of the example skeleton, and I think I've got the example skeleton here somewhere as an FBX downloads. Yeah, there. So you can get that on the UDN as well. You probably noticed there a couple of edits during the video. I had a little bit of problem with the graphics card driver I downloaded today, and the computer crashed. So there we go. Anyway, the other character's done. You can use this one if you wanted to rig your character using this, the skeleton that's underneath this mesh. Or you could, for a sample or for a tester, you could go over looking at the skin weights on this and get an idea of how it all works. All in all, that's the Maya series, part of the series, finished now. I'll show you the completed character of Epic Mio 5 that we just imported at the beginning of the video. There he is, he's got a different material on here. All done. And then we could look at him in UDK. With his other material on, that is. And hopefully it's been of use for you, this Maya series. But obviously the series in itself hasn't finished yet, because there's quite a few Max videos to go setting up this Facefx. So I think we're going to go for... No, we're not. Let's shuttle some crap down here. Right, characters. Where are you, Adrian? Oh. There he is, right. And there we are. Mr. Adrian. As I mentioned before, the head comes out of the... It's a bit far back. I could have deleted the skin envelope and reskinned it a bit further forward. But it's not the end of the world, you know. He does his job. He's all there in the editor. I fixed a couple more weights off air. There's still a bit of work to do to him. It's just a process of going back over and fixing everything. And then in Maya you can actually get auto rigging software plugins for it and that, so you could mechanize your method of rigging if you wanted to. Same with Max, you could create a Max script for rigging if your characters all have a similar style or a similar stance, that is, this kind of posture. Then it would be very easy to create a Max script or a Maya script to automate the process, but that's way too much to go over in this series. And so this is the end of the Maya series, and I will see you in the next one, which is part 10, which is back in Max. See you later.